Hey guys, it's Nir. Welcome to the fifth part of making a 2.5D game in Unity series. In this video, we will combine various camera design methods using Cinemachine. First, we will create a basic camera that follows our character. Next, we will create control zones that change camera properties like zoom when the character is inside it. After that, we will add a track and a dolly camera. And last, we will configure the camera to follow two or more characters. Let's start by downloading the Cinemachine package. It's an excellent extension for Unity that provides us with an outstanding AAA-like camera controls. In the menu bar, go to Window, Package Manager. Wait a few moments for the list to update, find Cinemachine, and click the Install button. While it installs, I will mention that in this tutorial I'm using Unity 2019.3, but it should also work with the future version and previous versions as well. After the installation, we have a new menu with predefined Cinemachine objects, but for now, let's add the components manually. I created a scene that we can add to all kinds of camera controls, but first, we need to set our camera. Select the camera object and add the Cinemachine brain component to it. With Cinemachine, we only use one camera, and instead of modifying its state directly, we use multiple virtual cameras and transition between them. Go to the Cinemachine menu and select Create Virtual Camera. Name the new object VCam Main. Drag the character from the hierarchy window to the Follow field. This will set the camera to follow our character. Set Body to Framing Transposer and Aim to Do Nothing. Set its distance to 13 and make sure the virtual camera rotation is set to 45 degrees in the x-axis and 0 for the rest. We can now play the game and have the camera follow after our character. But we can leverage Cinemachine to have a smoother feeling movement. When the camera zooms in and out, I want it to have a bit of more damping, so I'll increase the Y and Z damping to 2. Since we generally want the character in the center of the screen, we will set the soft zone to 0.4. We can also set the dead zone to 0.2, so the camera won't move if the character only moved by a bit. The anchor point of my character is at the bottom, so I'll shift the screen Y position a bit by setting it to 0.55. Let's run the game to see the changes we made in action. There is one thing we need to do before we start coding the script. Go to the character object and set its tag to player. We will use it in the script soon. Next, let's create our camera control zones. These are zones that while the character is inside them, transitions to another virtual camera that better suits the zone's environment or gameplay purpose. Create a new mono behavior script and call it CamZone. We start by creating a field of type Cinemachine Virtual Camera and name it Virtual Camera. If the type isn't recognized, make sure you include the statement using Cinemachine. We want to disable the virtual camera until it's needed, so on the start method, we disable it by writing virtualCamera.enable equal false. Now let's add trigger collision methods. Create an onTriggerEnter method, and only when the colliding object had the tag player, set the camera to enabled equals true. We can do the same with the method onTriggerExit, but this time, set the camera to enabled equals false. We said we need a collider for this script, so let's ensure that the user always has a collider on the game object. Go to the class definition and add the required component attribute. Pass it with the type of collider. We can also ask the Unity editor to make sure the collider is a trigger. Add an onValidate method. Inside it, use getComponent of type collider and set its isTrigger value to true. The script is ready. We can now create camera control zones with it. Create an object, name it CamZoneGate. Add a collider of your choice, mark it as trigger, and set it as you please. I created a capsule around the gate. Add the CamZone component to it. Duplicate the VCam main object and name it VCam gate. The gate camera will activate as the character goes near the gate. We still want it to track the character, but it should zoom in. To zoom in, let's set the distance from 13 to 8. Now, select the gate zone object and drag VCam gate into its camera field. We can now run the game and see how the camera transitions between the virtual cameras as we approach the gate and move away from it. Notice that we still have a single camera. It's just the active virtual camera that changes. We can see in the scene view how it works behind the scenes. One thing I want to change before we move on is the transition duration between the virtual cameras. select the main camera game object, and in the inspector, go to the Cinemachine Brain component. Change the default blend to 1.2 seconds. Let's go to the other side of the level and create a zoom out zone. Duplicate the objects CamZone Gate and VCam Gate. Name the zone object CamZone File and the virtual camera object VCam File. Move the zone to its proper position. To set the zoom out, change the virtual camera's distance from 8 to 16. We can run the game and see that when we reach the end, the camera zooms out. Now, let's do something else. Instead of changing the camera's distance, let's set a zone where the camera is static and doesn't follow the character. Once again, duplicate the CamZone Gate and VCam Gate objects. Name the zone object CamZone Start and the virtual camera object VCam Start. In the virtual camera, change the body from Framing Transposer into Do Nothing. Position the camera as you wish and run the game. Now, when we start the game, we will have a static camera that only starts following the character once we exit the cam zone we created. To create a dolly cam, first duplicate one of the cam zones and name it Cam Zone Dolly. Adjust the trigger to contain the whole dolly zone. Go to the Cinemachine menu and select Create Dolly Camera with Track. Name the camera object VCam Dolly, and the track should be called Track Dolly. Drag the new virtual camera to the cam zone we have created. Now let's configure the camera, set the follow to follow our character. Make sure the body is set to track dolly. I added some damping, mostly for the x-axis. Open the auto dolly settings, tick the enable checkbox. Set position offset to 5 and set resolution to 10. Last for the camera, make sure aim is set to do nothing. Go to the track object and set the path you desire. You can add as many waypoints you need. Run the game. We now have a dolly following our character. The advantage we have with the dolly is that we can control some near camera objects for a parallax effect that works great with this style. Tracking multiple players instead of one is not much different than what we have done until this point. It requires a target group to follow and a distance range instead of a static distance. To add a target group, go to the Cinemachine menu and select Create Target Group Camera. In the targets, drag all the characters and set an appropriate radius depending on the size of the characters. The virtual camera is already set with the target group as the follow target. A difference to note is that we no longer have a static distance, we instead define a distance range for the camera. As always, the project is available to download at GitHub. The link is in the description below. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed or learned something new, please consider to like and subscribe. We have more Unity and Spine animation tutorials coming up soon, so stay tuned!